Happy birthday!
If you were falling.
Happy birthday, Mom. I can't believe you're 60 years old. That's crazy to me. What do I want to say to you on this birthday video? Well, there's a lot that come to mind, so let me try to narrow it down to just a few things. I guess mostly on your birthday to this year, I want you to know, first of all, just how much I love you and admire you, and I just want you to know that you've left a footprint on my heart, on my life, and you've definitely shaped me as the person I am today. When I think about some of my very earliest memories of you, I think about how you, there's a couple things. First of all, you always told me that I was your little buddy. And that's a memory that goes back as far as my mind can remember, is you always said that I was your special little buddy, that I was your little friend. And along with that, the other thing was that we had a little song together, and you always sang me, "You Are My Sunshine." And just that to me set the tone for our relationship since I was a kid and into adulthood. I remember as a kid just thinking how special I was that you weren't just my mom and I wasn't just your daughter, but that you were my friend. And that to me, I remember thinking that was so cool, that that was unique, that my mom and I were friends. She wasn't just my mom, she was my friend. And the whole "You Are My Sunshine" song, same impact. It just made me, you made me feel special, and you made me feel loved. And because of that, I try to have songs with Molly and Noah that are just our songs. And forever, that "You Are My Sunshine" song will always be our song. And I know that I'll tell my kids about it. You know, this is me and my mom's song. And it's a little thing, but it has always made me feel special and loved. A couple of other memories that stick out to me a lot that I love to think about. Saturday mornings after you'd pick me up from ballet. And this was even when I was older, you know, junior high school. You would take me to Chevron, and we'd always get a Coke and nuts, and we'd sit and eat our peanuts and our almonds or cashews, usually cashews actually, and we'd eat our nuts and sip our Cokes and just talk. And I remember a lot of those talks. I'd ask you a lot about your childhood. I wanted to know about everything. Tell me about your childhood, your relationship with your friends and your parents, and what it was like growing up when you were little. And I would just fire questions at you, and you'd tell me story after story, and just undivided attention and time you gave me to just talk. And I remember in those moments thinking, this is one of those things I'll tell my kids about, you know, Cokes and cashews and talking with my mom every Saturday morning after ballet. And it is a memory I cherish a lot, and I learned a lot from you back then, and I've always taken to heart your advice. And I know you know so much, and you've always been an example to me. And so that memory, another one comes to mind. I jump in the car after school. I mean, cars, me and you were always running errands, and I'd always go with you, and I'd sing you songs in the car, I'd tell you stories in the car, read you books in the car. Those are great memories. But I remember specifically after school, when I'd come jump in the car, I'd say, "Mom, what'd you do today?" And if you started giving me a generic answer, I'd stop you and be like, no, like, you dropped me off from school, then what? And I just didn't like the thought of being left out of your day. Like, that's not what friends, you know, do. Like, we don't like to be left out of each other's life. Like, I wanted to know, from the time you dropped me off till now, like, tell me everything. And then, after you'd tell me every little detail of your day, without even asking, you know, you asking me, I'd jump into my day. So you dropped me off, and I went to did this, and first in math, and this friend said this to me, and that to me, Mom, speaks volumes of you as a parent. Just, you're such a good friend to me, and you're so easy to talk to, and you'd always listen. As long as I'd let you into my life, you were more than willing to be in, and helpful and loving and supportive, and that has taught me so much as a mom. And my relationship with Noah and Molly, I can only hope and dream that it's like ours, because I hope they talk to me like we talked, and I hope they listen to me like I listen to you. And to me, that it's not that I'm not the factor there. To me, it just speaks about you as a mom. And you've just taught me so much about motherhood, and you have glorified it in my eyes. And I'm constantly surrounded by friends and in a world today that devalues mothers. But I was raised by you, and you always made it seem like the most noble, important thing you can do in this life. And I know that that's true, but I learned it from you. And so thank you for that, and thank you for always being there and for being my friend. I will always, always talk about you as my best friend. And I could take hours on a video telling you all my favorite memories of us, but I won't do that, you know. But I want you to know that I do just wanted to pull some specific thoughts from my mind of how much I value our friendship and our relationship, and I want to thank you for your example. To put your life aside to have 7 children blows my mind. You are one of the most selfless people I know. And still, your kids are grown, and you sacrifice day in and day out for them, and you do it with a smile on your face. And when I watch you with my kids, with my nieces and nephews, the love you show them, the patience, I mean, you literally kill yourself worrying about your kids and your grandkids and serving them to the point of exhaustion. And that is incredible to me, Mom. You're one of the most Christ-like people I know. So thank you for that example. And there's no words to thank you for everything you've done for me, for my kids, for my siblings, for my nieces and nephews. And I just want you to know that I notice it, and that I appreciate it, and that I love you for it. And I hope this is a special birthday. I hope you like your surprise. I hope you like this video. And whenever you are too hard on yourself, which you often are, and whenever you don't realize how amazing and special you are, which often you do, please turn on this video and watch it and know how much we love you and care about you and admire you. So, I love you. Happy, happy birthday from your youngest, from your little buddy. I love you forever. Happy birthday, Mom. Say hi, Gaga.
Hi, Gaga.
Say, I love you.
I love you.
Say, happy birthday, Gaga.
Yeah.
Say, happy birthday.
Yeah.
Can you say, I love you?
I love you.
Say, thank you.
Gaga.
Yeah. Can you say, thank you for everything, Gaga?
Gaga.
Can you say, thank you for going to Colorado with me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you say, I love you, we had fun?
Okay.
Yeah. Say happy birthday, Gaga. Say happy birthday.
Birthday.
Say I love you.
I love you.
Say bye, Gaga.
Bye, Gaga. Bye. Gaga.
Say bye, I love you.
Bye, Gaga. Bye.
Happy birthday. I will be brief. I know that Mallory probably already took up 20 minutes to record a video because she has so much to say. So I second everything that she says. I know she looks up to you a lot as a mother, and she loves the advice that you give, so she probably had at least 20 to 30 minutes worth of material. So again, I'll be brief. Happy birthday. I just want to say thank you again for everything that you do for our little family. You do so much for us. And I don't feel like we ever thank you enough. So thank you. One thing, or a few things that I love about you, as I've gotten to know you since high school, number one is your ability to cook for an army at the drop of a hat. It's impressive. Number two is your storytelling. I love listening to your stories. I always have. I think you need to write a book. You've got all kinds of good stories. And the third thing that I really love about you is your selflessness and your desire to serve and to help others. You're a very Christ-like person and such a good example to all of us and your family and everyone around you of how we should treat others and how we should sacrifice and put others' needs first. That's something that I've really taken to heart as a parent and watched your example. So thank you for that. And again, happy birthday. I love you, and thank you for all that you do.
You rock my world, baby. You're so awesome. Some might say you're tubular. The moment I was born. From the moment I was born, you've brought me joy and happiness. You're my bridge over troubled water. You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a record. Right round, round, round.
Where's Paul?
Mom, you're the best. You deserve the best of all days. I love you with all my heart. And I want you to soar on your birthday.
Happy birthday, Gaga. I love you.
Paul, can you say happy birthday, Gaga?
Margaret? Margaret Bruff Wallstrom? The MBW? Maggie? Margie? Mags? M-Town? Margo? PTA? PTO? No. The Chief? Gaga? Grandma? Maglite? Big Wig? The Mama? Abuela? The Dairy Princess? Miss Kaysville? The Tip of the Top? The Cream of the Crop? The Queen of the Yacht? The one, the only, Margaret Bruff Wallstrom. So many things to so many people. You mean so much to all of us. The best of birthday wishes to you, Margaret Bruff Wallstrom.
You're unbelievable.
I love you, Grandma Moggy, because you bring you with us books.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Love you.
Love you.
Bye, Grandma Margie.
Bye, Margie.
Go.
Happy, happy birthday. I hope this day is so fantastic, and I wish that we could be there with you. I love you the most because of how kind and generous you are and how sweet you are and how you're always, always, always willing to give to others and help out. And that is definitely one of my most favorite things about you and something that I strive to want to be like one day. We love you and we miss you. And like I said, I hope it's an amazing day. Happy birthday. Bye.
We're going to push
this one right.
Hi, Grandma Margie. I love you because you take us to the park and buy us new toys. And happy birthday, and Colt's up next.
So, I'm here in Houston, kind of far away, but never too far away to send happy birthday greetings to the Momma. So we were asked to put together a lot of, I guess, fun memories and just some messages for the Momma. It's hard to pinpoint one, to tell you the truth. As far as all the memories go, there's all those times that for instance, in elementary, I mean, I can't count how many times I called you in the middle of the day and was like, hey, drop everything you're doing and put Ebony in a doggy carrier and get her over here. Oh, and by the way, it has to be in like the next half an hour because I have to show her for show and tell. You did that like 3 times. I think I did that to you 3 or 4, maybe even times. And you always did it. The van, that's an iconic thing, right? The blue or the red van pulling up, you know, it's school ended 15 minutes ago and I'm all annoyed because I had to wait for like 5 minutes and like mom comes rolling in the parking lot and two other kids are in the back. Mallory's like throwing on her ballet stuff and Meredith's changing from her ballet stuff into harp clothes and, you know, you've got my violin or whatever it was you were trying to get me to do at the time and, like, you got it all together and I'm all annoyed because I had to wait and, you know, you put that together, but, the fanny packs, you know, I know he's always making fun of that, but I don't think you understand how much I loved the fanny pack when it came to family vacations. That thing was Mary Poppins' bag on crack. It was awesome. Anything I wanted was out of that fanny pack. You know, you just pull right out of there. It was awesome. But all-time favorite memory of my mom. Well, not the all-time favorite, but like one that I love. Happened to her maybe 3 or 4 times. And it was the Halloween day, you know, I'm sitting at my desk and writing my, whatever you do in elementary, I don't know what you do in elementary school, and just down the hall, the cackle, you know, just come and just reverberating off the walls, and like, the kid next to me starts to like shake, and I'm pretty sure a girl starts to like scream. And like people are wondering who this weirdo is that's coming down the hall and you just look so scary. I'm pretty sure 1 year, I'm not even making this up, a kid peed his pants in my class. I'm not making that up. He peed his pants. I don't think I ever told you that. It was awesome though. I love the fact that my mom for Halloween would dress up, and that's me because I love Halloween too, but she would dress up and do that. I know you got your own little pleasure out of it. You know, you go to like the supermarket and scare the crap out of like random people. But as a kid, that was awesome to me that you would do that. And as an adult, I think back on that and that's like symbolizes a lot of like just your willingness to be involved in our lives. And that goes along with the van and the fanny pack and everything else. You know, it's something that's rare. I don't think I realized that moms were anything but like my mom until I got in high school and, like, you know, some of my friends' moms were, like, worried about their lunch dates and their hair appointments or whatever it was they did. And they seemed, it seemed so selfish, and they're always, like, trying to be, like, cool moms. And I was like, I just have a real mom who cares about me and would do anything for me. And that is very appreciated. I mean, motherhood and fatherhood, for the most part, but motherhood is a very thankless job, and you performed it without expecting anything in return. And I think I can say that honestly, that it's a very special and unique thing. And I know you always talk about how you say this a lot, and I think you mean it, but you say that you don't deserve your kids. And I think that's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard, because none of us deserve to have a mom like our mom. And anything, any sort of boost or need that I needed or any want growing up was made available through you. And can't help but just be in awe that I somehow lucked out to have a mom that was as unique and caring and special as my mom. So happy birthday. Thank you for everything. It's a very empty phrase, thank you for everything, but I don't know what else to say. I could sit and bore you to death and make a list, and you know, it would take all night long, and but that's all I can say. You know, any sort of moral backbone I have comes from my mom's teachings, and I thank you for that. I love you, Mom. Happy birthday, and I hope everything is going great. Love you. Bye.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
All right. Okay. And Harry, what's one thing that you love about Gaga?
I like her when she takes me to play toys with me, with Marty.
Yeah. And Marty, what do you love about Gaga?
Ariel.
You love Ariel. And what about Grandma do you like?
Jasmine.
And Jasmine. Perfect. Anything else you want to tell Gaga?
Bell.
Bell. Okay, good.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mama. Happy birthday to you. The blinds are open. Hi, Mom. I just wanted to tell you that I love you very much, and happy birthday. Can't believe you're 60. You seem like you're still 30. I remember, seems like just yesterday, you were picking me up from ballet, and me and Charlotte begging you to take us to our circle to get hot fudge cookie crunch shakes, and I'd have it eaten by the time we pulled in the driveway. Yeah, you taught me well. Remember you taking us out for ice cream after we made cheerleader, and you just supported me through so many things. You encouraged me to do so many activities, ballet, harp, swimming, singing, which I'm not very good at, but sewing, I mean cooking, I can't, I, you all the things that I know how to do is because of you, and you encourage me to do those things. So I just want you to know that I appreciate that, and I love you so much, and you're one of the most giving people I've ever met or been able to witness in my lifetime. So I hope that I can be as good of a mom as you, and I have a lot of hard work to do to get there. But I love you, and happy birthday.
Hey, Mama. Happy birthday. 60 is it's an awesome age. It's totally the new 20. And I just want you to know that I love you very, very much. I have two memories of you that that really stand out. And one was at our last family reunion when you busted out this amazing some sort of foreign accent, of which I cannot pinpoint at this current time, but when you were being our judge for the Master Chef, and I just remember you saying that our cookies had too much butter. And I'll just never forget that I put too much butter in those cookies. But the other thing is that you always tell me how much you love me, and that you always don't call me your son-in-law and just your son. And you're just amazing, Mom. And you do it all, and you do it with a smile. Thank you so much for taking care of me and my family, and especially Marianne. You know she needs all the help she can get right now, and you've always been there for her. I will say that I don't know that I've ever met anybody that gives as much as you. You give of your time, you give of your effort, you give of your spirit, you give everything that you have in order to make other people around you happy. And I love that about you. So thank you. Happy birthday. I love you, Mama.
Hi, Mom. Happy birthday. I love you, and you are so cool. Like, really cool. You're very special to me, and we've been good buddies for a long time now. I love my day of funs with you. You're so fun to be with and hang out with. Our trip to the Bahamas. Oh, you're just a good travel buddy. The time we went to Spain, you know. But that cruise was fun, the time I had with you. You're a good person. And I'll always, always love hanging out with you. I love you, Mom. And thank you for everything you do for me. Thanks for always being my mom. No matter what, no matter how old I get, your role as a mother will always be, you'll always take that role as very important, and never stop caring and loving for me. You're cool. Okay. Well, I love you, and I'm very proud of you for all the service you do in the community, and you're just a very caring person that just gives and gives and gives, and I'm proud to be your son. I'm proud to tell people that you're my mom. I love you. Okay. Bye. Okay, bye. 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 Okay, now bye.
Go.
Happy birthday to you. Chop, chop, chop. Happy birthday to you. Chop, chop, chop. Happy birthday, dear Grandma. Happy birthday to you.
Chop, chop, chop.
I love you because you take us places, like get here.
Peter, what do you love about Grandma?
Lions.
Yeah.
Lions.
Does she play with you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Isabel, what do you love about Grandma?
She loves how she's sweet and kind to everybody.
She is, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Barry, what do you love about Grandma?
So many bears. First up bears.
Tell me some of the so many things. So fun. You love to play with Grandma, huh? Okay, what do you guys say?
Thank you!
Yay! Thank you!
Happy birthday!
Cha cha cha!
Happy birthday!
That's kind of creepy, huh? Sorry. Mother, I just want to tell you, as I'm sitting here contemplating life in my bed, how much I love you. Happy birthday, Mom. I'm gonna keep this short, as I'll get sentimental and cry. But you've always been there for me. And it's been rough the last year, hasn't it? And a lot of things have changed, but one thing that hasn't is your love for me. Trust me, I do know that you love me. But sometimes you let yourself forget how much you are loved. Not collectively, but individually as well. That includes me. I still have the same admiration and love that your little boy had when he made you shake and bake all by himself. I mean, I had to have been like 8 or something. That was amazing too. So thank you. More importantly and more recently, thank you for looking past my weaknesses, and please know that you are loved by my whole family. Happy birthday, Mom. Okay, that is kind of creepy. Peace.
Hi, Mama.
Hey,
okay,
Mom.
We're all trying to fit in here.
Whitney wants to be the center.
So if you look at the green dot, that's looking at Mom. So happy birthday, Mama.
Yeah, happy birthday.
We're going to try to see if Whitney can sing happy birthday to you.
Can you sing?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Gaga. Happy birthday to you!
I love you, Gaga!
Yay! So, Mom, I'll just say a quick... I'll serve as voice for the family. We couldn't be more grateful to have the most perfect grandmother ever for our little daughter. And you've been the perfect mom to me as well. Ever since I was a little boy, I always felt a connection to you and Dad, because you both were the oldest in the family, and I was the oldest in this family, and so I've always felt like, you know, we kind of got each other, and we're out of the same mold, and I'm just very proud to have you be my mom and to call myself your son, and I love you very much.
Yeah, I also feel very lucky to be a member of this family and have the opportunity to call you Mom. You are the most thoughtful and unselfish person I know. You literally wear yourself out in the service of others, and you're such a great example to us. We love you so much. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Love you. Bye.
Bye. Bye, Kaka.
Say bye.